As Major League Baseball stands coming to the end of the 2022 season in the run-up to the playoffs, the question kind of has to be asked. Who is the best manager in baseball and why? My answer is Jose Alexander Cora of the Boston Red Sox, despite the Red Sox being pretty much out of the playoff picture. Why is that? Let's talk about it. If you look at Alex Cora as both a human being and a baseball man, it is difficult to not see, upon further review, all of the qualities that make him an incredibly valuable part of an organization. The first one is communication. He speaks both English and Spanish perfectly, which allows him to do more in the clubhouse with all the players he encounters. Most of the players in the MLB are English or Spanish first language, and so that allows Cora to develop a more personal rapport and greater trust, which is huge in coaching in all major leagues today. The second element is Cora as a player was a very peripheral guy. He was a bit player, a guy who was struggling to keep himself in the major leagues on a consistent basis, which actually, compared to a superstar, gives him more credibility as a manager. Because when he has to have a difficult conversation with someone, when he has to ask someone on his team to take a lesser role or less playing time or fewer at bats, he's asking them to do something that he did on a consistent basis, year in and year out, wherever he played. Cora was not the most talented player, far from it, but he consistently did the little things to help his team win. So when he asks his players to do the same thing, it comes from a place of both experience and credibility, and that's huge. The next part is strategy. Cora's teams have consistently overperformed, and not just in the regular season, but specifically in the playoffs. If you look at the talent that he's managed in Boston, other than 2018, his teams have consistently overachieved, including this year where the Red Sox haven't been good. But if you look closer, there's actually significant overachievement to be seen even in 2022. This year's Red Sox team, incredibly flawed, lot of depth issues which have been exposed by injury, but still, after a tough start, from game about 20 to about 80, this was a very good team, a team that was vastly above 500, and a team that masked its flaws really well by getting the most out of the guys it did have. That's the mark of a good manager. And 2021, you saw a lot more of that. The Red Sox were a solid team, certainly better than this year, and they were buoyed by a couple of trade deadline acquisitions like Kyle Schwarber, but they were still not as good as the Blue Jays, a team that they beat out to get in the playoffs. They then beat a Yankees team that they were about even with in the one-game wildcard playoff, and then they beat the Rays, who won the division by a country mile last year, in a quite convincing fashion. The Red Sox then went on to the ALCS, where they took a 2-1 lead and looked like they had a chance to beat a Houston team that was much better on paper, as they've shown again this year. Houston has a ton of talent, and they should have won that series, which they eventually did. But the fact that the Red Sox were able to take a lead is just a credit to Cora, his strategic elements, and his ability to put his players in the best position to succeed. And of course, the crown jewel for Alex was in 2018, when the Red Sox went wire to wire, completely dominant performance. That team was obviously excellent. It had Mookie Betts, it had Benintendi, it had Chris Sale, it had David Price, who was actually excellent in the playoffs. But the team itself got the most out of the players that it had, which was why the team was so balanced and so dominant through every quadrant of the season. The Red Sox beat a very good Yankees team in the first round. They dismantled Houston in the ALCS after being down 1-0, won four straight games, and then they beat a very good Dodgers team in the World Series. Obviously, talent was the key element to that championship, but to be the best team in the history of an over 100-year-old franchise, you have to have the team firing on all cylinders, and Alex Cora had them doing that from point A to point C that year. A tremendous accomplishment. Now, obviously, the element that is the most difficult to come to terms with, the elephant in the room, which there always will be for Alex Cora, is the fact that he was an architect, if not the architect, of the Houston cheating scandal. The question has to be asked, was he punished enough for that key role? And my answer is no. I think he should have gotten 2 years instead of one. But at the end of the day, the bigger punishment is not the number of games missed or the number of games that he was not allowed to manage or bench coach, as was his role in Houston. The key thing is that every managerial accomplishment and his accomplishments as a player are tarnished by the fact that in the first paragraph of his baseball biography, there is going to be a part written about Cora as a cheater. He cannot run from that. He cannot hide from it. It is a reality that is there forever. And when one is constructing a legacy, that will always be there. And that, to me, is punishment enough in itself. And certainly that's the biggest punishment that someone has to suffer. Just ask Pete Rose, just ask Barry Bonds. And in terms of runner-ups, Terry Francona has done a tremendous job with a very young and overachieving Cleveland squad this year. He's had to manage a difficult outfield filled with younger players, and he's done a very, very good job with his bullpen. That team, if they win the division, will be a tremendous credit to Terry. And we can't, of course, forget about Brian Snitker, who has done an absolutely unbelievable job in Atlanta for multiple years now, winning a Manager of the Year award, plus multiple playoff series in 4 years, capping it off with a World Series title in 2021 and an excellent follow-up year thus far in the regular season in 2022. He has created a ton of momentum in Atlanta following their rebuild, and he deserves a tremendous amount of credit. And then finally, Oliver Marmol, a guy who has shot up through the Cardinals organization extraordinarily fast. Marmol has done a really, really good job as a young manager. That team is rocketing to the top of their division. They've discarded Milwaukee, and they look like they're going to win that division quite handily. And that's a guy who I look for as someone who's going to develop into a stalwart manager, a guy who's probably going to win at least one, if not multiple, World Series in the future. Thanks, and have a great day.